Unturned 4.0 Devlog 14. It has been a while since we last had a devlog, and that is because Nelson has moved into a new apartment, and it took him a while, but he's finally done with everything, so that is why we've had so little updates regarding 4.0. First of all, I'm gonna quickly talk about the most recent update for Unturned 3.0. At first sight, it looks incredibly boring, but it was actually a real good update, especially since I've recently started streaming Unturned on a daily basis again. Quick plug, link is in the description, twitch.tv/mtngg. Once this video is up, I'm actually gonna be streaming Unturned, so if you want to check that out, go ahead and do it. So basically why this update was so good is that cheaters used exploits to crash servers and user clients, meaning that they could shut down a server by pressing on one button, and same goes for when they crash an individual player. That has been fixed, and me and many other streamers have had a hard time streaming on turn, as we were getting stream sniped by these cheaters who crashed our servers that we played on. Now to the more interesting stuff. In this devlog, Nelson has posted a video showing off Maya, which is a 3D modeling program, and this also released an animation tool with the character model for Unturned 4.0. You will find the link to the devlog in the description so that you can set it up if you want to. So earlier this year, we got to see the Unturned character model shooting an eagle fire, and from what I understand is that Nelson had to animate the character model and the weapon separately, which took much longer, and with this new animation tool for Maya that he has made, he can animate it much faster, and he only has to connect the arms of the character to the weapon, and he can basically work on animating it. Super simple, and it makes it so much faster, and he can also press on one single button. Just by pressing on one button, he can get it into the game. Super cool. Very cool. Nice. With this tool, you can also get the option to look at how it looks in first person holding the pistol, as you can see in this video that Nelson made.
So you can get an idea of how this animation will look in first person.
What you have to remember is that this is not the final product. This is in the earliest stages of Unturned 4.0 and will be changed a lot throughout the many updates to come. From what I understand, you can also add your own objects to the project and connect them to the arms. As you can see here, Nelson added a simple sphere and connected it to the arm of the character, and now that he moves the character's arm, the sphere moves with it as well. That is a pretty good way of showing how much easier it is. So if you would start modeling stuff for Unturned 4.0, such as weapons, then you could add it to the project or the rig, as he calls it, and you can look how it looks in first person and so on. That is pretty much it, guys. I don't have anything else to explain. If you want a more detailed explanation of the animation tool, you can find Nelson's video in the devlog through the description. Don't forget to subscribe and like if you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video, everyone. Don't forget to stay coffee.